Hi everyone, welcome to this tips and tricks video. Today we'll be looking at the toggle world local gizmo axis. This option is over here in the toolbar. It's here, toggle local world axis. Let me show you an example. Here in my project, actually it's the demo scene that we just added to Twinmotion 2022. You can find it in the burger menu, demo scene, lake house retreat. I wanted to add some dead leaves on the top of my roof. So I just opening my library here using the search bar, I've typed leaves, and now I can simply drag and drop that dead leaves 04 on my roof. As you can see, the stack of leaves is toward the top of my roof and I would like it to be at the bottom. If I just use my gizmo over here to rotate it, as you can see here, by the way, this is a decal, it's a projection of a texture on a geometry. And as you can see here, when I'm turning that object, I don't see my decal anymore. It's because it's turning over that Z axis that is pointing straight up using the world axis. What I would like to do is that axis to be straight based on my decal that I have here. And this is what this option do. If I click on that toggle, it will switch to local gizmo. And as you can see, it's not facing straight up anymore. It's facing the direction of my decal. So now if I'm looking at my rotation gizmo here, I can just rotate my decal and place the stack of leaves toward the bottom. Now, if I want to move my decal, I can use any of the two axes over here, the dark bar, or I can also press this area and move it on two axes at the same time. If I want to duplicate that object, I'm just going to switch to the rotate tool. I'm going to press shift and click on that arrow, and I'm going to just duplicate that mesh over that specific axis. Now let's have a look at another example. I will open my scene graph. Here I've added just a basic geometry, a prism. Let me now, in my library, have a look for a car. If I drag and drop this car, as you can see, it's placed that way on my prism. But let's say I want that car to be facing on the right. Same thing here, if I select my car and if I start to turn it while using the world axis, as you can see here, my car will either start to collide with my geometry or will start to float in the air. Again, this is also a use case where you will want to use the local axis. Here, when you switch to local, same idea, if I turn that car, it will still be aligned on the floor and the four wheels will be still sitting on that prism. And that's it for these tips and tricks. Thanks to everyone for joining me, and I will see you guys for the next one. Bye everyone.